Good day and welcome to Scholars Universal School Online Classes for Season of Science. Today we'll be having biology, and in biology we'll still be discussing about tolerance and adaptation. So we're going to look at adaptation of the parasites. We all know what parasites are. They are organisms that feed on their host to gain their own food. So this is a tape one. So you can see the diagram of the tape one. We have the hook, we have the scolex, the scolex is the head, we have the sucker, we have the hook, we have the ostellum, we have the neck, we have the mature prolocid and mature prolocid. This mature prolocid is like egg. So these are the young eggs. Why the big ones, why the mature ones are the ripe eggs? Then the sucker and the hook are used to attach to the organism. So now let's look at the adaptation of the tapeworm itself. So tapeworm possess hooks on the scolex for attachment to the gut wall. So they live in the gut wall of their host. So they possess hooks on the scolex, which is also their head, in order to attach. It possesses suckers for attachment to the gut wall. So the hooks and the suckers are used for attachment to their host gut wall. Please note that it has a ribbon like flat or tape like body to fit into the gut of the host. So that light is being called the tape worm, because it has a tape-like body to fit into the gut of its host. It has a fast rate of proliferation of proglycins to ensure survival of the organism. That means it reproduces at the fast rate. In order for it to reproduce its eggs at the fast rate, so it would survive easily. Large surface area of its body allows absorption of food from its host. So the surface area of its body is very large, so absorption of food from its host will be very easy. The surface of its body is thin and permeable and allows rapid absorption of food. So if the enough for a tapeworm to be able to absorb food rapidly, its body is thin and is very permeable, so it allows rapid absorption of food. It is a hermaphrodite that allows successful reproduction. Hermaphrodite meaning it has both male and female sex cells or sex organs, so it reproduces by itself, so this allows successful reproduction. Now let's look at the adaptation of another animal. Now here we are having the toes, so you can see the head, the nostril, the mouth, the eye, the low eyelid, the tympanum, the parotid gland, the forelimb, the ventral side, the dorsal side, the wads, and the hindlimb, the vent. Now let's look at what all these contribute to the toes in adaptive feature. So the adaptation of toad, the first one we are having is for food. How does he adapt to gain food? It possesses a special olfactory organ in the head for smelling and perceiving the odor of the food. So in its head it has an olfactory organ. The olfactory organ is the smell organ. So in your nose you have olfactory organ, but in the toad it has a special one in its head, so it can perceive the food, the odor of its food from a distance. It has the ability to draw eyes in so that it can make bulges in the root of the mouth, which helps the prey to prevent the prey from escaping. So it can draw its eyes in. So this will now allow the root of the mouth to bulge up. So when the prey is inside the mouth, the prey can't escape. So they have successfully caught its prey. The tongue is attached to the front of the mouth, which can rapidly extend to capture prey. We've all seen or watched a video of a toad catching fly. You know that they will extend their tongue and drag it back in. So the tongue is attached to the front of the mouth, so it can easily come out of the mouth and will rapidly extend and to capture the prey. The tongue is long and sticky, so for it to be able to hold the prey at that instant, the tongue must be long and sticky, so the stickiness will allow the prey to stay on the tongue, then it can stay far away from the prey and to still catch the prey. The tongue, which is long, helps in catching the prey, like I've said. So still on the adaptation of toad, now let's look at for protection. How does the toad protect itself? Now what does it possess to protect itself? The skin is slimy with mucous gland, which makes the animal difficult to grab by predators. So the predators will find it very hard to grab the toad because it is slimy. So as they are holding the toad, as the predator is holding the toad, it will slip away. So it will make it difficult for the predator. Slimy fluid keeps the skin moist and prevents the skin from drying. So this slimy fluid will allow the skin to always be moist and can not allow the skin to dry up. Because if the skin is dry up, the predator can easily catch the toad. Toad has poison glands on the skin, which are poisonous and distasteful to the predator. So it has poisonous glands on the skin, such that when the predator is about to eat it or bite it, it will release its poison. So it will now be poisonous and distasteful to the predator. Brownish color or cryptic coloration helps to blend with the color of the surroundings. So the toad are usually brownish in color, so, and they are usually found in where moths are. So they would blend with their surroundings. So it is hard to see a toad in its environment. The color can be altered to match the types of background. So any type of background they are, they can alter their color. So if the toad is on a green leaf, it will turn and to change its color or alter its color so that it can match the type of background. So in order for predators to not quickly detect its. So, adaptation of toad. Now let's look at how it adapts to movement. A toad has a long hind limb with powerful muscles, which helps it to hop and jump efficiently away. So, when you see a predator, it is due to its long hind limbs, which are powerful, it can hop and jump away. Absence of tail facilitates hopping and jumping movement. So, it does not have tail, the toad does not have tail. So, it's allows the jumping and hopping movement to be easy. Webbed hind limbs can be used as part for effective swimming water. So they have webbed hind limbs. That means there is something like a blockage between the finger. Like if you should look at your finger, you will see that there is a skin between each finger. So in the toad, it is covering the with covering each finger, so it can be used as paddle, so it can paddle through water. The stout and short nature of the forelimbs absorb the shock on landing and for propping up the movement, the front end of the body after and landing after a jump. So the forelimbs will absorb the shock and they would be used to prop up to jump again. So it's now prop the front end of the body on landing. So it will allow the front end of the body to go up so that the hind limb can come down.
Able to not be affected by landing on its face on jumping. So we've looked at the adaptive feature of the toad for food, for protection and for movement. And also, it possesses a streamlined body for easy movement and swimming. So the body is streamlined in such a way that it finds swimming and movement easily. Adaptation of hydrophytes. We talk about the hydrophytes. Hydrophytes are plants that can successfully live in an aquatic habitat. So now let's look at their adaptive features. Some hydrophytes lack or have reduced roots or root hairs. That means some hydrophytes do not have roots. Some have reduced roots. Or root is. Hydrophytes do not need firm anchorage in water or wetland. What this is saying is that they do not need something to hold them down in water or wetland. Hydrophytes possess large airspace parenchyma in roots and leaves, which provide support for buoyancy. So they have large airspace in their parenchyma, which allows them to float on water. Presence of hairs on the leaves to prevent blockage of the stomata. So there are hairs on the leaves to prevent the blockage of the stomata. The stomata is the where gases are passed through in the leaves to get to the chlorophyll. So they have hairs on their leaves to prevent blockage. So that's some adaptive features of the hydrophytes. Then They also have numerous adventurous roots and root hairs, which is absorption of water. Since they are living in water, their roots will be scattered and it will have more roots, so they will quickly absorb water. Possession of small size for buoyancy and floating in water. They are usually small in size so that they can easily float in water. Presence of waxy upper surface of the leaf to prevent clogging of the leaf by water. So the waxy surface will make the leaf hard. So the movement of water will not allow the leaf to fold up. Presence of breeding roots or pneumatophores for breeding or gaseous exchange. The breeding roots or pneumatophores, they are the ones involved with gaseous exchange in some hydrophytes, especially those that live in the mangrove swamp. Now, this is adaptation of zoophytes. So the plant you are looking at here is the cactus. So now let's look at the adaptation of zoophytes. Zoophytes are animals that are plants that live in very dry areas. So they have possession of thick succulent stem or leaves for storing water, reduction of leaves to spines to reduce water loss rate of transpiration. So their leaves are reduced to spine, so that they reduce the rate of transpiration. Thick waxy cuticle on the epidermis to reduce water loss or transpiration. Possession of long taproot system to obtain water from great depth of soil. So since they are living in a very dry area or the desert, their root system will be very long and it has to be a taproot system, so it will go deep down into the soil to get water. Presence of sucking stem to reduce water loss. Reduce number of stomata to prevent excess water loss. The stomata is where gas is coming or go through the leaves, so the number of stomata is reduced so that it will prevent excessive loss of water through vapor form. Possession of multiple epidermal layers for water conservation. So they have multiple epidermal layers for their water conservation. So this is where we stop the class for today, and we have our tree with tolerance and adaptation. Go through other videos to revise on this topic. Thanks for watching. Till we meet in the next class, we'll be discussing a new topic. Like and subscribe to this channel for new videos or new updates. And if you feel like you need some information, contact us on this WhatsApp number and visit our website www.scholarsinversalschool.com for more information. Thank you for listening.